there was a man who came from the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when they were about to go out into a battle. I'm not sure if it was the battle of Badr or Uhud. I'm not sure it was Uhud or maybe a battle after that. So this man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have come to bear witness that there is only one God worthy of worship and you are his messenger. I've come to accept your deen. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after explaining it to him, he made bay'ah, he pledged allegiance to this religion and bared witness that there is only one God and you are his messenger. The call to jihad was there. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, you know, since you've just become a Muslim, you need to sit down and learn your deen. You're not obliged to go out right now. It's okay, you're exempt. You know what that sahabi said? And I don't know his name, subhanAllah. In fact, in the books, his name is not mentioned. Why? Because the focus is not about names. The focus is not about identity or color or background of their culture. This is not important whether they are men or women. It doesn't matter. The actions of a person and their intention is what gives you the merit, not your color or shape. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I did not become a Muslim to sit lazily there while watching my brothers and sisters being massacred and hurt, but rather to defend them in the cause of Allah and for an arrow to enter into this side of my neck and exit through this side. And he pointed with his finger. Rasul, when he saw his determination, he said, very well then, okay, come along. How can I deny you, Firdaus? He went along and fought. The Muslims were victorious. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, being the compassionate, loving Rasul of Allah, rahmatan lil alameen, a mercy to all of mankind, he was the one who remembers those one or two people who no one else remembers. So he went looking for this sahabi. He couldn't find him. Finally, he found him on the floor with several of the mushrikeen around him, and he had killed them, and he was dead in the middle of them. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at him and saw exactly where he had pointed to his neck. An arrow had entered from here and exited from there. Allah had given him exactly what he wanted. Listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. This is the point. Bakhin bakh. This is an Arabic statement, sort of expression they used to use when they are, you know, something is out of the ordinary. He said, bakhin bakh. Far out. Wow. Well, what do you know? Like that. Bakhin bakh. Rajulun دخل الفردوس الأعلى ولم يسجد لله سجدة. A man enters the highest places of paradise that any person can reach with the prophets and the martyrs, and he has never prostrated once in his life. La ilaha illallah. He enters al-Firdaus and his head never touched the ground in prostration once in his life. This is a hope for us, inshallah, that sometimes we do a small act, and sometimes we cannot do so many major acts, else we couldn't do them. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you enter the highest places of paradise. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, it is not about quantity of action, but rather it is the quality of the action.